excused. And I'm not your bra.
They bought it. Incredible. One of the worst performances of my career, yet they never doubted it for a second. How could I possibly be expected to film the cold open at school on a day like today? This is the fifth time I've had to bring one of Tauchi's cameras home to film something. If I go for six, I'm probably gonna have to barf up a lung or something, so I better make this one count. The key to filming a good cold open is filming at home. I'm a big believer in it. A lot of people will tell you that filming at school is the way to go, but the thing that happens is if you don't get everything done in the hour, you gotta stay after, which that's worse than homework. So you check out a camera, and then when you bring it home, you film a parody of one of your favorite movies, which may sound a little bit silly, but then again, so's most of the show. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around for a little while, you might miss it.
Hello, FHS, and welcome to another episode of Flagstaff Avenue.
We're excited to see you guys again, and I know we've been talking a lot about prom, but recently the prices have gone up to $60, so you want to get your tickets now.
Yes, registration ends on May 7th at 11:59 p.m. with no exceptions. You can buy your ticket online, and the link and more information can be found on the FHS Student News and Announcements page on Schoology. Also, Friday and Saturday are the last two shows for the Little Shop of Horrors musical at 7 p.m., so you definitely want to buy your tickets and don't miss out.
And we also have the baseball team here today to tell us a little bit about baseball and what they're doing with, or like how they're going this year. Now let's send it over to them.
Hi guys, thank you, Katryna. I'm joined here with the captains of our very own Farmington High School baseball team. Could you each introduce yourself and how long you've been playing baseball?
I'm Owen Schmidt, and I've been playing baseball since I was 5 years old.
And I'm Luke Walton. I've been playing since I was about four or so.
I'm Sawyer Hoffman. I've been playing since I was four.
Awesome. And as you guys may know, athletes put a lot of work into the off season. Could you, each of you guys talk about what that looked like for the Farmington baseball program with a younger roster this year?
Preseason, everyone's getting into the captain's practices, working hard, trying to show what they got, and that's a really good place for everyone to show.
Yeah, along with captain's practices, everybody does their own stuff, whether it's like club or, you know, working out, lifting weights. It's been awesome so far.
Yeah, just captain's practices are a big thing, and then also getting a lot of work in on your own.
Yeah. By the looks of it, you guys have had a pretty loaded schedule so far. Could you talk about some of the successes and difficulties you as a team are working on?
I think we've already seen a lot of good things. It's just about piecing it together and working together down the road to make it all come together.
Yeah, I mean, our pitching has definitely been a strength of ours. These two guys next to me have been doing a really good job. A few too many errors, but, you know, it'll all come around.
Yeah, obviously with a schedule like this, it gets loaded into a couple weeks, and you basically got to play back-to-back days and just work hard and do the work.
Absolutely. And then for those of you who may not know, our Farmington baseball team, looks like we actually got some footage up here of you guys' latest evening game. Do you guys want to talk about some of the things that went well for that game for you guys?
We had a lot of timely hitting, and in big spots when we needed some guy to come up with a clutch hit, they came through.
We were just fighting for runs early in the game, and then we were finally able to, you know, scratch a few off at the end to put us up five or so, but yeah, it was a really good game.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, close game early, and then this guy next to me popped it off and hit a home run.
There you are, Big Soy, hauling it down base. Look pretty excited about that. That was funny.
Smacked my hand nice and hard, though.
Yeah. And for those of you who don't know, our baseball team has actually made a couple of appearances in the state championship over the past couple of years. Do you guys want to talk about what it was like to compete in the championship and the steps you're going to take to make another appearance this year?
I think it's a great step for our program moving forward. I don't know the last time we've been in a big game like that, but it was really big for everyone involved.
Yeah, I mean, it was crazy. It was just surreal playing at Target Field and all those nice fields, and yeah, I mean, it was just awesome.
Yeah, games like that, they create culture, and that culture will be around for long after we're gone.
Absolutely. And speaking of moving on, each of you guys are continuing your baseball career in college. Do you guys want to talk about the commitment process and how Farmington baseball has helped influence you into the athletes you are today?
Yeah, it's taught me a lot about teamwork, integrity, sportsmanship, and perseverance. And that's really helped guide me to taking a level to the next step.
Hot shot over the top of New into center.
Got to play at three here.
Play at three, though. Nice throw by George.
A lot of learning moments.
Yeah, me and Owen are going to Winona State. It was just kind of getting it, putting in the effort, doing the work, and obviously Farmington baseball was a big part of that. They developed a work ethic and developed me into a good baseball player.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much for coming down. I'm going to throw it back to Hailey and Katryna.
Great season so far. Mm-hmm.
And now we have a segment where you, FHS, have a substantial impact on the segment. This is the third installment of Ox Battles. Let's take a look.
This is Ox Battles, a game where I give our Instagram followers a prompt, they submit a song that they believe best fits the prompt, and then get put up against each other after I put all their submissions in a wheel spinner. The winner is decided by the opinions of other people within the school. This idea comes from a YouTuber by the name of Pat CC, but this is the third episode involving FHS. Let's get into it.
It's about drive, it's about power. We stay hungry, we devour. Put in the work, put in the hours, and take what's ours.
Out this way, doing all these shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I keep paying. Bad little fight, she been on my mind.
So this picture is basically a football game. It's taken from the sidelines, and it's in the middle of the action. And I don't really know exactly how else to describe it. I would say that Face Off would probably be the song that I think fits it best. It's just kind of like everyone's trying their hardest to win, and I feel like that song's just I don't know what to say. And that song just fits the picture.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with Holly. I think that it's like kind of like has some sort of intensity in it, and I think that Face Off is a good fit for this picture.
All right, so this first photo is a football game, and you know, football game, Friday Night Lights, that's kind of the vibe. So that's why I'm going with Kanye, All of the Lights, for this one. I feel like that song just kind of matches the tone of the photo, matches the football game sort of mentality, and yeah, that's why I'm going to go with that one.
All right, so for the first photo here, we have the photo from Homecoming this year where we played Edina. And for this one, I'm going to have to go with Run This Town by Jay-Z and Rihanna. I don't know. It just fits the theme, and I really like that song compared to All the Lights by Kanye. Another very, fitting song for this picture, but I just got to go with Jay-Z on this one.
Yeah, so this first picture, I'm going to go with All of the Lights. I just feel it represents the football theme pretty well.
Yeah, I'm going to say All the Lights also. I could tell that Ethan Geisler kicking it, so we know he missed. And but basically, it just reminds me of Pedros when he used to shine out there on those Friday Night Lights. Great ball player.
Mm-hmm.
for life. Chicago that time, I'm beside. Wonderful vibe, wonderful night.
Okay, so I feel like this picture kind of has, like, I don't know, like, weird, kind of creepy, suspicious vibes, I guess. I don't really even know how to describe it. It's just, like, weird. But honestly, like, all of the song suggestions, like, I didn't really feel like any of them, like, personally, I didn't feel like any of them really fit very well. But if I had to choose one, I don't know, I think Little Dark Age kind of has, like, I don't know. I feel like the monkeys spinning monkeys is just like, just like too silly. And it's just like weird, weirder than that. So I don't know. I guess Little Dark Age is my choice.
I agree. The vibe of the picture is weird. I have no idea how to describe it, but I disagree. I think monkeys spinning monkeys is the right choice for it. It's a weird song and it's a weird picture. So, I mean, yeah.
So, you know, I'm not all caught up on rap stuff, but I do believe that that is Lil Durk. And the photo, it's kind of a funny photo, so that's why I'm going with Monkeys Spinning Monkeys by Kevin MacLeod, because it kind of gives off that, like, funny mentality that the other songs don't really give off, and I feel like it definitely matches the photo the best out of all of those songs. All
right, and then for the second one here, we have a Lil Durk. You know, I mean, man, you know, He really be something. With that one, I'm gonna go with Monkeys Spinning Monkeys. I mean, it's just like the silly, random TikTok song that is what I connotate that with. So, you know, we're just gonna go with that for this one.
So personally, for this picture, I would have chose a Yeet song, but I gotta go with Trance.
Be Quiet and Dry is a pretty good one, I'd say. Otima would probably choose Yeet as well.
OT's looking pretty good up there.
That's it for Ox Battles this week, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks to all those who participated over on our Instagram. If you guys have any thoughts on the segment itself or want to participate in the next Ox Battles, go over to our Instagram page, at fhs.flagstaffav, and be on the lookout for updates regarding the segment. Now, let's bring it back to the studio.
Thank you, Ashton. Mm-hmm. I like that segment. I think it's pretty fun.
I do too, you know. And Hailey said she changed one of her options.
Yeah, you know, I first didn't agree with the monkeys spinning monkeys, but I don't know, everyone else seemed to, so I guess I
think I
agree
the monkey spinning monkey matches.
Yeah. Well, today we have the Link crew down here to talk a little bit about what they do and how you can apply next year. So let's throw it over to Link crew.
Well, thanks for the toss. My name is Mr. Paul. I'm one of the Link crew coordinators here at the high school, and I'm with
Dylan Henriksen,
a future and former Link crew member. We're here to talk about Link. Most of you know and have been through that process, but we're at that application time for our next year's Link crew members. Dylan, you were just a Link crew member. What was your maybe favorite memory of being a Link crew member?
I think really, you know, May Day was a fun experience, being able to relive my ninth grade experience, and of course in learning in the summertime, learning how to, of course, lead those activities and then heading over to actually the first day of school and having fun with, you know, the ninth graders.
And what do you think, first, fantastic, what do you think was maybe one thing that you got out of Link crew, being a member?
Definitely leadership experience, you know, really learning how to lead, especially with how, you know, these kids are coming into high school and they're not necessarily, the building's new to them, and so having them, showing them around, and then also having them build relationships with some people around them is always helpful.
That's fantastic. Yeah. Fantastic. So we had a couple of informational meetings, and if Link crew sounds like something that you want to join, I believe, I think we're going to have a little graphic here to show kind of how and maybe what, right? There's a Schoology course there on the screen, and you maybe have seen the posters all wrapped around the building. To join that Schoology course, and then there's a two-part application. It's just a simple Google form and then a short essay to write and answer a question about yourself. And so look for those posters around there. Applications are due at 3:15 tomorrow, 3:15 yeah. Friday, and so maybe try to beat the rush and get it done a little bit earlier.
Exactly. Yeah. Join Link crew.
Thanks so much, Dylan. We're going to send it back to wherever.
Hey,
Thanks, Mr. Paul.
You know, I've had like a week and a half to write that essay, and I still haven't wrote it, so I needed to get that done.
Definitely get that in if you're looking to apply.
Oh, yes. And then Jace Ritchie ran around the school again for this week's installment of Drip Check. Let's take a look.
All right, guys, welcome back to Drip Check. Try and keep up.
All right, I'm here with
Andrew.
And Andrew, I see you have a few accessories on here.
Yeah.
Yeah? Can you show it off? Oh, shoot. All right. How many watches do you have on?
Four.
Four? How much did they cost you?
One was 200, the others were 130.
All of them were 130 except one was 200?
Yeah.
Okay, how about the sunglasses then?
500.
500?
Prescription. Yeah.
Prescription sunglasses, I like it, you know? Pretty drippy. I give you a 9 out of 10.
Thank you.
I aspire to be like you, Boogie.
Thank you. I'm famous.
I found a pool drip here, guys, so I'm going to ask you guys what's your name and how much your outfit costs, all right?
Oh, my name's Olivia, and my outfit costs like $150. My name's Ava, and my outfit's like $280.
$280?
My name's Katie, and I think we're going to say like $150.
$150?
I'm Nicole, and I'm going to go with $250.
$250?
I'm Brynn, and I'm going to go with $310.
All right, if anybody wants to count out how much that was, then feel free to do so, because I'm too lazy. Yeah. What's up?
What are you wearing, and how much does that cost?
Shoot, you guys want to ask what I'm wearing? Okay. So my dad bought me this shirt. I have no idea how much it costs. I say around $50. Yeah. I got this broken watch right here. It's stuck on my birthday, 15. It was like $30. It wasn't broken when I bought it, but it was $30. Got some nice black pants I bought recently. They were about $30 too. And I got some nice, I don't know what brand, but black shoes that I wear almost every day. So, yeah, I give myself a 10 out of 10. For you guys, I don't know. All right, I'm here with
Zach Potter.
And Zach Potter, what do you have on today?
I'd say like a chill fit for today.
Nice, nice. How much did it cost you?
The shirt was like $20.
$20?
Pants, like 30.
30?
Shoes are like 120.
How about the bracelets here?
One of them was 20, one of them was 50, so I'd say like 70 for the...
Okay. Chain?
Or a couple of chains. I got like 250 total on the chains.
250 total. What do you think, Alex?
Approved.
$400 for outfit.
$200 for the whole outfit, guys. What do you guys think? $400. Never mind. $400, guys, for the whole outfit.
I'm just guessing.
He's just guessing. Okay. I'm here with my sister. And would you explain your names?
Reese.
Hailey.
And Reese and Hailey, what do you have on today?
This is like $110.
Yeah, $110. Mom wasn't happy with that.
Oh, mine's $208.
Oh, at least it's not $208, Reese. Then there you go.
Okay, well, she's wearing like all Lululemon, so.
Oh, of course. How about the AirPods?
The AirPods? Oh, those were pretty expensive, you know?
How much?
I don't know. I got them for Christmas. I think they're like probably like 80. I don't know.
80 for 100, 80 for AirPods?
Yeah, AirPods are expensive.
I thought it was more expensive. Okay, tune to the next person. All right, I'm here with Mr. Lund. And Mr. Lund, what are you wearing today?
I'm wearing some jeans and a shirt.
Nice. You know what brands?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Can you say what brands?
I think I'm wearing some area jeans, a cool shirt.
Cool shirt? Can we see the cool shirt?
A shirt under it.
Yep.
And a t-shirt.
Nice, nice. How much do you think it cost you, the whole thing?
Well, funny thing, a lot of viewers might know this, but I do a lot of shopping on eBay because I like to win things.
No joke? Oh, you won it?
Yeah.
Nice. So the whole thing was free?
No. Oh, no.
Oh.
But not very expensive either.
Okay. So I guess... If you're just like Mr. Lund here, you have to go shopping on eBay and win something. So, thank you, Mr. Lund.
My pleasure.
Okay. All right, I'm here with... Not enough drip, apparently. Zero drip.
Thank you, Jace.
Thank you. Frank, why did you run away?
Yeah. guess, and,
yeah,
like Jay said, not trippy enough.
Yeah, I guess not. But as some of you know, Will was a bit stuck trying to decide what his top 10 was going to be. So you sent in your ideas on our Instagram page, Flagstaff Avenue. And Will, listen, let's find out what this week's top 10 is.
Hey guys, welcome back to the top 10. Thank you so much for all those who participated in our Instagram poll and voted their opinions as what to as to what today's top 10 topic should be. Thankfully, we've landed on top 10 2000s kid nostalgia, like memories or moments or items. I don't really know. Anything, if you're a 2000s kid, anything on this list should trigger you back to being like a kid again, hopefully. So without further ado, we're just gonna jump into the number 10 spot and talk about VHS tapes. I vividly remember having one of those small box TVs and then like at least a couple dozen copies of like old Disney movies and like the golden age of Disney. So like Lion King, Aladdin, Emperor's New Groove, and those like white, nearly impossible to open VHS cases. Maybe I'm reaching to you guys, maybe I'm not. I don't know, maybe I'm just dating myself. I don't really know here. At the number 9 spot, we have Pillow Pets. I feel like everyone had these as a kid. You know, which one you had definitely said a lot about who you are as a person. I myself had a penguin, and for some odd reason, I named it Barricade after a Transformer. Not sure why, but I did. At the number 8 spot, we have Field Trip Day in elementary school. Pictured here, we have the Shark Tank Touch Aquarium at the Minnesota Zoo, along with the Safari exhibit, and then some of the dinosaur exhibits at the Minnesota Science Museum. You know, I just remember going on a lot of field trips as a kid throughout first through fifth grade and just having a lot of fun. You know, it was always a good day at school when you knew you were getting out. Thank you so much, Mr. Tauchi. He actually brought a VHS tape. What some of you may not know is this is what movies used to be played on. You'd throw them into a little 19-inch box TV and watch them on these. So, yeah. At number 7, we have playing a Nintendo DS. I had one of these as a kid and absolutely loved it. My favorite games were probably Star Wars The Complete Saga, Super Mario Bros., and I had a game that allowed you to play some older arcade games. But really, there's just a wide variety of games that you could play on the DS. Who knows, maybe I'll make a top 10 DS games list later on. Might be a topic. But yeah, I just had a lot of fun playing my Nintendo DS. Definitely helped kill the time whenever I had a long car ride or I got up super early in the morning. At number 6, we have PBS Kids. And see, the beauty of PBS Kids was it was free, so basically everyone had access to it. Everyone had their own unique take and own favorite opinion as to what was their favorite show. Mine personally was Curious George. I watched a lot of that, but then I remember also watching a lot of Wildcrats. I was very big into nature and animals as a kid. And I also watched my fair share of Clifford the Big Red Dog. So, you know, just a really big and wide variety there. At number 5, we have listening to classic rock with your dad. This is kind of a niche memory. Some of you may have had it, some of you may have not. I just remember sitting in like the middle row of my family's minivan and listening to classic rock as my dad would drive to like Home Depot or something or run errands. You know, usually you just had to like tag along at that age. But you know, extra props to you if you have this same memory and have it in a like Chevy Suburban or a minivan. All right, Frank's kind of gesturing me to move on here. So we're gonna move into the number 4 spot with playing a Nintendo Wii. A lot of Nintendo on here, guys, but Nintendo really knows how to make family consoles and make them enjoyable. You know, last year I did the top 10 Wii games, so you guys kind of know my take on that, but I still play my Wii to this day with my younger brother Ben. We make an emphasis to play Mario Kart on any given holiday and name it after that specific holiday, so like we have a Christmas cup, Thanksgiving cup, what have you. At number 3, we have elementary school holiday parties. I mean, really, it just doesn't beat this. There's no finer occasion to attend. You know, you have the leprechaun absolutely trashing your classroom. I remember coming back from recess a couple times and being pretty livid that the leprechaun did that. We had the Christmas and Halloween parties. Halloween was always my favorite, but Christmas was cool too. And of course, we had Valentine's Day where you got free candy and you just, I don't know. There's really no feasible reason why we should have had that day off, but we did. And then at number 2, we have summer days outside, man. I mean, every kid should have done this at some point in their life. You know, you always had the fun with the above ground pool, with the water slide, going down to the park playing baseball. I was a big kickball guy myself. You know, freezies, which were able to replenish us after spending a long day exhausted outside. And that some of you may remember like those weird green electrical boxes that were in some of your yards. I don't know, in my neighborhood, I know that we made like an emphasis to make that like a safe point for whatever like tag game we were playing. But guys, moving into the number 1 spot, really I feel there's fundamentally no other debate for the number 1 pick. And And the number one pick, guys, is parachute or scooter day during gym class in elementary school. I mean, you walked into the gym, you saw either scooters or a parachute on the ground, and you just knew it was gonna be a good day. Wide variety of games to be played within the parachute. Being inside the parachute itself is kind of a surreal experience. I don't know how to describe it. And then scooters were fun until you either jammed your fingers against another scooter or got them run over, in which case it really hurt because your finger's being crushed. But guys, that being said, that's gonna wrap it up for the top 10 this week. I'm gonna throw it back to Hailey and Katryna.
Thanks, Will. I like that top 10 this week. Might be my favorite one so far.
Do you know the 90s rock one with your dad, or the early rock one? That one was like top notch for me and my dad. We still will drive around and listen to like classical rock. It's amazing.
That's fun. Mm-hmm. Well, back again for its second update is Katryna, an update on Katrina's puppies.
The puppies are walking around now. They're like not crawling, but like actually walking around. Mm-hmm. They're very talkative. They'll be downstairs in their little den area, and we can hear them like barking from down there. And it's so adorable. And the only not adorable part is when they pee on you. I had that happen to me last night.
Yeah, it's not fun, but they are super cute.
They are. But are you ready for this week's phone booth?
I am. Get your guys' phones ready because we're going to throw it over to Frank and Baiden for another segment of the phone booth.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh. Welcome back to the phone booth. I'm Frank Mooney.
And I'm Baiden.
So for our first question here, pickles start out as which vegetable?
Wow, that was quick.
You're live.
Frank?
Yep, this is Frank.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
You know, I'm doing all right. You excited for the game today?
Yeah, real excited.
Grizzly.
It's going to be a big game.
Yeah, it's going to be a big game. But so for my answer, what was the question again?
Pickles start out as which vegetable?
Okay, for my answer.
It's a tough one.
Steve Duro gave me this answer.
Okay.
And I'm going to go with cucumbers.
Cucumbers is correct.
Steve Duro was right.
Hey, nice talking to you, Resny.
Shout out Steve Duro.
So for the next question.
All right, this one was sent in by Brian Resny, and this is who painted the Mona Lisa? 2644.
You are live.
Leonardo da Vinci?
That is correct.
Nice.
Got him.
All right, so the next question is, how many bones do sharks have? 2644. Oh, wait. We'll get a call. You alive.
Oh, do you think I could get two large pizzas?
No, wrong number. You're alive.
Hi.
You got an answer to the question?
Is it Ryan Pettis?
You're live.
Oh, it's zero.
Yep, zero's correct.
Nice.
What? And you got this one?
What is the rarest M&M color?
Rarest M&M color. You're live.
What is the question?
What is the rarest M&M color?
I don't know the rarest M&M color, but I do know people who would know the rarest.
All right, that's all for the phone booth today. Now we're sending it back to the studio.
Thanks, you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Every week is always interesting.
Oh, yes. And thank you guys for tuning in again this week.
Yep, we will see you all again next Thursday for our next episode. And don't forget to buy your tickets for Little Shop of Horror this Friday or Saturday at 7 p.m.
Don't forget.
Yes. Have a great day, FHS.